Hello, fellow bibliophiles, and welcome back to Blatantly Bookish. I'm Marissa, and today I thought I would have a little chat with you guys about the Brontë Project that I'm doing on my channel this year, and give you some updates as to what to expect for the rest of the year regarding the Brontës. So first of all, yes, the Brontë Project is still happening. I know that I haven't filmed a video about it in a while, but I've been keeping up with the reading, and I hope you have as well. Since 2021 is over halfway done, I just wanted to remind you guys about the rest of the Brontë read-alongs yet to come. For August, there are two options for the Brontë Project that might interest you. The first one is to focus on the Brontës' poetry. Of the three sisters, Emily is the most widely celebrated poet in the family, but Anne and Charlotte wrote poems as well. I have this tiny little bind-up, Dover Thrift edition of the three sisters' poetry that I've read before, but I'd like to read again. Or perhaps I might end up looking for a more comprehensive collection of Emily's poems. We'll see. The other option for August would be to read a modern retelling or a modern work of fiction about the Brontës. Two that I know of and might be interested in reading are The Glass Town Games by Catherynne and Valente, which is about the fictional worlds that the Brontës created in their juvenilia. And I also have a digital copy of Brontë's Mistress by Finola, which is about the scandalous love affair between Branwell Brontë and Lydia Robinson, the mother of a student that he was tutoring. Somehow my studies of the Brontës have omitted this affair of Branwell's. I've heard of Branwell portrayed as a drifter and a drunkard, a failed artist, but I've never really learned much else about him. And if all else fails, I can always read an old favorite of mine, The Eyre Affair. This book is only loosely connected to the Brontës. It's about an alternate version of England, where time travel is routine, cloning is a reality, and literature is taken very, very seriously. Our main character, Thursday Next, is a special operative in literary detection. And when Jane Eyre disappears from the pages of Charlotte Brontë's novel, Thursday is tasked with entering the novel and tracking down the villain to preserve the beloved story. It's a really fun read. Anyway, I would love to hear some more suggestions from you guys about modern retellings of Brontë books or modern works of fiction involving the Brontës, or their characters, I suppose, in the comment section down below. And of course, if you're feeling extra excited about the Brontë Project, you can read poetry and a modern work of fiction relating to the Brontës for the month of August. Then in September, I hope you'll join me in reading a book that is near and dear to my heart, that I read almost every single year, and that, of course, is Jane Eyre. Here's my very beat up copy. It's the coming-of-age story of an outcast orphan named Jane Eyre. We follow Jane's life with her neglectful aunt and cousins to Lowood Charity School and onto Thornfield Hall, where Jane becomes a governess for a charming little French girl named Adele. But something seems a bit off at Thornfield Hall, and Jane begins to unravel the mysteries of her employer's past while trying to secure the happiness that she deserves. I love Jane's character, her tenacity and persistence. She's just such a subtle character with so much beneath the surface, and she's always appealed to me, so I can't wait to revisit her with you in September. In October, we have another one of my favorite Brontë books, and that is Wuthering Heights. This is another book that I read multiple times and I can't wait to reread with you. Wuthering Heights is an atmospheric, somewhat spooky book set on the wilderness of the English moors, and it follows the intense relationship between Cathy and Heathcliff and their subsequent generations. It's not a romantic love story, which is a misconception that a lot of people seem to have, but I love this book because there is so much to think about and unpack, and there's always something new to take away from it. So I hope that you'll consider reading it with me. This will be my fifth or sixth reading of it, and I'm extra excited for this read-along because for October, the Brontë Project will be colliding with Victober. So I'll be hosting this read-along with Kate Howe and a whole lot of other wonderful booktubers. There are also talks of a Zoom discussion. The details for this are all still in the works, but I'm sure there will be a more formal announcement as we get closer to October. And then November is traditionally Nonfiction November on BookTube, and surprise, surprise, I was hoping to read a work of nonfiction about the Brontes. Any biography will do, but perhaps you might want to check out Elizabeth Gaskell's biography of Charlotte Bronte. I read it before and it's really interesting. I personally have acquired this book, which I've wanted to read for ages, called The Bronte Myth by Lucasta Miller. It discusses the Brontes as cultural symbols and examines how their lives and works have been perceived over time. The author looks into how Gaskell's biography encouraged this legend of the Brontes as these three lonely sisters living out their tragic destinies on the windswept Yorkshire moors, with chapter titles including The Angel in the House, Secrets and Psychobiography, Fiction and Feminism, Interpreting Emily, and The Mystic of the Moors. This book really speaks to me, and I can't wait to read it. I've actually picked it up from the library before for Nonfiction November, I think, but I had to return it before I got past the first chapter. So now that I have my own copy, nothing can stop me from reading this one. For November, there's also a whole discussion thread all about recommendations for nonfiction books on the Brontes that you should check out if you want to participate in the Brontë Project for the month of November. That's all on the Goodreads group, which I will link down below. December will be a catch-up, wrap-up, and reflect month when it comes to the Brontë Project. I have yet to decide if I'll use it to read another book or to simply reflect on a whole year of reading the Brontës. We'll see. You can choose to use it however you would like to. Consider it a free month. Since there are two options for August, you might actually want to use the month of December for the one that you didn't get to. It's just a bit of extra time to use as you wish. So that's the rest of the year for the Brontë Project. You may or may not have noticed that I'm already working on uploading the Goodreads discussion threads for the rest of the year. I was working on putting together a Shirley video, and I wanted to read your comments while thinking about the book. And then I felt terribly when I realized that there were no comments about Shirley because there was no Shirley discussion thread. I thought I had posted it at the end of May. It was checked off my list that I posted it. So I don't really know what happened, but I'm just sorry that I didn't post them earlier. Anyway, it's posted now, and if you'd like to discuss Shirley there, you can. Like I said, it's not going to be an issue again. All of the threads will be posted in advance for the rest of the year. I am so excited for the second half of the Brontë Project, and I do hope that you'll join me. What aspect of the Brontë Project are you most excited for in the coming months? I can't wait to hear all of your Brontë-related thoughts and comments in the comment section down below. And until next time, I look forward to seeing you all in another video very soon. Bye!